Hey, what's up, YouTube fam? Brandon Weaver here once again. I've got a couple amazing emails for you, so let's get into it. Hey team, thank you for the wonderful help, all right? This individual has received 50% discount and deletion from the credit report for the last stubborn collection. They've got all the other negative items off the report, but this one's still lingering for some reason, but got a response from a collector saying, hey, we'll discount it 50% and we'll delete it from your report. So individuals out there who are thinking about doing a pay for delete, you might even get money off. Now, it isn't always necessary. This individual has gotten a lot of negative items off as well at 609creditpair.com, or we can do it for you at theawesomelifegroup.com. But they were saying, hey, look, it's the last stubborn collection. What do you think, Brandon? $370 to pay it and they'll take it off. Now, that, if that's in your finances and you can handle that and you want to do that and be done with these fools, so be it. You can keep disputing. If they have not gotten to you the 100% accurate information, okay, just like yourself, if you're out there, you're listening and you need to repair your credit, 609creditpair.com, where you can send out the letter, see if they've got any items for you that are 100% accurate with a signed contract with your name on it, or with a video of you signing a contract or something of this nature. Or we can find those violations for you at theawesomelifegroup.com, dispute on your behalf. So my pay for deletion, I didn't even get a 50% discount. I didn't get a discount when I had to do one. It was a pain in the butt. All right, they had sent me some documentation. I was like, okay, fine. But you're gonna delete it when I pay. They said, fine, they faxed over proof in writing, just like this person got something in writing. I didn't get a discount, so if you're getting a discount, that's really cool. It was a few hundred dollars for me back in the day, a long time ago, but hey, I looked forward and onward and it changed my life. That was the last stubborn thing for me as well. And I was able to boost my score. I was able to travel the world on the credit card sign-up miles, bonuses for free, changed my life, able to do a lot more and help a lot of friends and family along the way. And now I'm able to help you and have a business helping individuals do it, which is wonderful. I'm super happy that I'm super fortunate to be able to do it. So get these collections out of your life, move on. If it works with your finances, get these fools away from you because you've got bigger things to do, just like every one of us here is part of the Subscribe Tribe. So hit that subscribe button and that bell for notifications. All right, another great email here. This is fantastic. First round results coming in this week, all right? Most of which is laid out very clearly and I'm following your process. Thank you. I've already gotten 7 deletions on TransUnion. They were the first to respond, okay? I have a repossession from Ally Financial. I'm sure some individuals have dealt with Ally Financial and understand that this happens. Not a problem, we've got letters for it. It's also listed as a chargeback. I don't know if that's a different terminology for repos, okay? Do I send the original collection, the regular collection validation letter? Now, you can send the collection validation letter along with your repo letter. We're gonna get into that. Give me tight, Jerome. Repo letter, all right? Jerome doing an excellent job on camera. With your repo letter, you can get it at 609creditpair.com. We've got the Beyond Committed package all laid out for you, processed nice and easy. Thank you so much for your help. Score has gone up 25 points so far, but I'm expecting more soon, and you should. Your credit score will more than likely continue to go up. And this is the repossession deficiency notice letter. This asks them, demands the information that they are supposed to provide you. Please provide copies of the legal notices and proof of the commercially responsible manner of the resale of the subject of this vehicle, all right? If no such proof is given to you, then the alleged claim of deficiency will be considered null and void, and any continued collection activities or continued reporting of this invalid claim of credit reports will be considered a violation of FDCPA and FCRA. Y'all know that. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, Fair Credit Reporting Act. You can get this squared away the same way they send you a letter saying, hey, if you don't respond, collection agencies will say, they'll send you a letter, they'll say, hey, if you don't respond within 30 days, we're gonna assume this debt is yours, all right? And we've got letters where you can send them back. But you're sending them a letter now saying, hey, if I don't hear back from you in a certain period of time, your claim is null and void, and I will be seeking legal activity. And that collection validation letter, you send your 609 dispute letters, you dispute that negative stuff off, get this erroneous, inaccurate, unverified accounts off your reports right now. If this video helped you out, please give me a thumbs up. I really appreciate you guys. All the Subscribe Tribe here have been super supportive. I look forward to seeing you on the live stream. And until I see you in person, I will see you on the other side. Take care.